Muy buenas noches, amados amigos y hermanos.
Good evening, beloved brethren and friends present. It's for me a great privilege to be with you in this evening here to share with you some moments of fellowship around the divine program corresponding to this end time, so in order to know the things which we should know in this time from behalf of God and His program. For this occasion, I want to read in the book of Revelation, chapter 4, verse 1, where it says, "After this I looked, and behold, a door was open in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, Come up hither, and I'll show thee things which must be hereafter." May God bless our souls with His word and allow us to understand it. Our topic is what we need to know today. You may be seated if you don't mind. We are living in a time in which we need to know today these things which should happen soon in this end time, after those that happened in the past ages during these 2,000 years which have transpired from Christ up to now. Now here, this voice of a trumpet, the voice from heaven, the voice of Christ, in Revelation chapter 1, verse 10 to 11, we find this same voice speaking to John and saying, "I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day and heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last." Who is the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last? Well, our beloved Lord Jesus Christ. That is the voice of Jesus Christ in the last day, which is the last day. In other words, this is the seventh millennium, because a day before the Lord, for the human beings, is a millennium. There are 1,000 years. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8. And Psalm 90, verse 4, that is the Psalm of Moses, speaking on the same thing, that a day before the Lord is like 1,000 years. And now, the last day before God is the seventh millennium for the human beings. And that is the day of the Lord. Just like the seventh day of the week for the Hebrew people, it's the day of the Lord, the day of rest, the day of resting to be dedicated to God. Now the seventh millennium is typified in the seventh day of the week. That is why the seventh millennium is a millennium of resting for the earth and for those who will live on earth, because they will rest upon the affairs of this earth which they have on this earth. In the millennial kingdom, it will be a different way of life than what we have currently. It will be a kingdom of peace, of love, of harmony, of happiness, and of rest for the soul of the people. And we will not be living in the way like we live currently, with a lot of the cares of this world, of the earthly things. What will be the main thing for those who will live in the millennial kingdom? There will be things of God. Apparently, in the Gentile kingdom, the kingdom of Gentiles is occupied in material things, but in the kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ, the things of God will occupy the first place. The spiritual things will come first, and then after, the material things. And now, during the millennial kingdom, the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as the waters cover the sea, as it says in Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 14, and Isaiah chapter 11, Verse 9. The earth will be filled with the glory of God through the preaching of the gospel of the kingdom. And through the preaching of the gospel of the kingdom, which rotates around the second coming of Christ as the Lion of the tribe of Judah, as King of Kings, Lord of Lords, in his reclaiming work, it will be made known to the people, those who will live in the millennial kingdom. It will be made known, the manifestation of the glory of God, the glory of the Lord, in the second coming of Christ, as it has been in these 2,000 years which have transpired from Christ up to now. They have been making known the glory of God manifested in human flesh in Jesus, in the first coming of Christ, and the work of redemption on the cross of Calvary. And now, the earth will be filled with the glory of God as the seas are covered by the water. And the scripture says in Zechariah that all will know me. And also in another place it says, that day the Lord will be one and one his name. It also says that the Lord will be king upon all the earth, upon the Hebrew people and upon the entire planet earth. And now, you notice how the knowledge of God and his program will be made known to the human beings who will live in that glorious millennial kingdom, because what comes first is God and his program. That's how it is in the kingdom of God. In the kingdom of the Gentiles, it's not like that, but in the kingdom of God, sure, it's like that. Now, this voice like of a trumpet which spoke to John on the day of the Lord, in other words, on the day of the Lord, is the voice of the Alpha and Omega. And who is the Alpha and the Omega? Our beloved Lord Jesus Christ. It's not a trumpet sounding literally, but the voice of Christ speaking to his church on the day of the Lord, in other words, in the last day, in the seventh millennium. In that way, as he spoke to John the Apostle, he will speak to his church and will make known to her all these things which should happen soon in this end time. And these are the things which we should know today, in the time in which we are living in. Because if not, if it was not necessary for us to know these things, then why would God, Jesus Christ, why would he make them known to his church? It is necessary to know these things which should happen soon, because among the things which would be happening, one will be the principal, the greatest of all. And that is the second coming of Christ. And every human being knows that they need to know the mystery of the second coming of Christ in the end time. Because upon the second coming will depend the resurrection of the dead believers in Christ and the transformation of us who are living. And upon the second coming of Christ depends that we hear the great voice of trumpet, the final trumpet, which is the voice of Christ speaking to his church in the last day, in other words, in the seventh millennium. And how are we going to hear his voice if we don't know the mystery of his coming, to know that the one who will be speaking to us in the last day with that great voice of trumpet and revealing to us all these things, how shall we know if we don't know him? Now, through who will he be speaking to us all these things which should happen soon? Since the Lord will not do anything without revealing his secrets to his servants the prophets, Amos chapter 3, verse 7. Because God puts his word, his revealed word, in the mouth and in the heart of his prophets, so that these prophets can speak to the people of God that revealed word, and they speak it anointed with the Holy Spirit. And then, in that way, the Holy Spirit, through his prophets, he speaks to the people. You notice how he tells us, God through prophet Zechariah, in chapter 7, where we find the way in which God spoke to the Hebrew people. Chapter 7, on verse 11, it says that God spoke through the prophets, but for them they did not want to hear. In other words, the Hebrew people didn't want to hear, on verse 11, but they refused to hearken, and pulled away the shoulder and stopped their ears that they should not hear. Yeah, they made their hearts as an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts had sent in his spirit by the former prophets. Through the prophets, God sent his word. The Holy Spirit, through the prophets, he spoke to the Hebrew people, but the Hebrew people did not want to hear. Now you notice how God, through his manifestation in the Holy Spirit, in his prophets, he spoke to the people. He brought his word through his prophets. He brought all the divine revelation which comes through a prophet. A prophet sent by God for the time in which God is going to bring this revelation to the people. And now, let us see what he also tells us
in Deuteronomy, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 29, verse 29,
the secret things belong unto the Lord our God, but those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever, that we may do all the words of this law. And now, how did the word come? How has the word come? The word of God come revealed for the people? Through the prophets. The revealed things are for the people, and they are revealed through the prophets of God. And now, in Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15 and onwards, it says, Lord thy God will raise up unto thee a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren, I come to me, and to him ye shall hearken. Whom does God say that the people should hear? The prophet whom he raises in their midst for the people. He says, according to all that thou desirest of the Lord thy God in Horeb, especially in Sinai,
in
the day of the assembly, saying, let me not hear again the voice of the Lord my God, neither let me see this great fire any more, that I die not. And the Lord said unto me, they have well spoken that which they have spoken. I raise up a prophet from among their brethren, I come to thee,
donde podemos encontrar
and we
la palabra
put
Dios
my words in his mouth. So where are we to find the words of God in the time in which we live, in the time allotted to us to live in? We will find the word of God in the mouth of a prophet. And we have to know who that prophet is, the one who is announced in the scriptures. We should know that the scriptures speak about that man through whom Christ will be speaking to his church and will be showing her all the things which should happen, and that we should know the things which we should know in this end time. Now we have seen that the word of God is where? In the mouth of the prophet which he sends. And he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. What will that prophet speak? The one sent by God? Everything that God commands him to speak, whatever he puts in his mouth and in the heart of that prophet.
And
any person can say that they are not interested to hear that prophet because they are not interested in hearing the voice of God. But that does not make them free from the responsibility before God. A person has a free moral agency, has a free will. Every person has a free will to believe or to doubt, to be a believer or to be an unbeliever, to the word of God, what God speaks, what God says in his word. But every person is responsible before God, and every person will give account for himself before God. Now, for people who don't want to hear, for those who have not wanted to hear in the past times, when God has sent his prophets, look what will happen to them. And it shall come to pass that whosoever will not hearken unto my words which he shall speak in my name, I require it of him. That is so. It's a terrible thing for people who don't want to hear the voice of God through the prophet whom he has sent in the time, in the corresponding time, in the age or dispensation in which God has sent that prophet. In other words, that the people who act against that prophet,
la voz de Dios a través de ese hombre.
They are responsible before God to hear the voice of God through that man. A prophet is a man with two consciences together, and that is why he can hear from God and transmit the message to the people. And now,
veamos,
let us see in the book of Hebrews, chapter 1, where the Apostle Paul tells us about the prophets whom God sent. He said, verse 1, God who at sundry times and in divers manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the universe, the worlds. God spoke through prophets to the Hebrew people because he put his word in the mouth of prophets and they spoke that word. Later, he says that he spoke through his Son. He says, in these last days, he has spoken unto us through his Son.
And
also, he is also a prophet. Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth. And what are the last days? Because Paul already said that God spoke through his Son, through Jesus, the last days. And there we have already had 2,000 years from Christ up to now. The last days before God are the last millennium before the human beings. And these are the fifth millennium, the sixth, and the seventh. When Jesus had 4 to 7 years of age, the fifth millennium began, and consequently began the last days before God, which are the last millenniums for the human beings. And the last millenniums, the last millennia are the fifth, the sixth, and the seventh millennium. And the last millennium, which is the seventh one, before God, is the last day. It is in the seventh millennium, the last day before God, in which Christ will resurrect the dead believers, those who died physically, who were believers in him, and they obtained the new birth. And we who are living, he will transform us. All this is for the last day before God, which is the seventh millennium. This is the last day, the seventh millennium, where the voice of Christ will be heard in the midst of his church as the great voice of trumpet. This tells us about the voice of the archangel. When God spoke through the messengers of each age, he spoke through an angel messenger, and that was the voice of the angel. That was God speaking through a messenger, the message corresponding to that age. And later, when he speaks in the last day and makes known to us these things which should happen soon, that is the voice of the archangel. That is the voice of God through a dispensational prophet speaking to his church. We have seen that the great voice of trumpet is the voice of the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, that is our beloved Lord Jesus Christ. That is the voice of Jesus Christ speaking to his church, all these things which should happen soon, which are the things that we need to know today. And now, through who will he be speaking these things, and which things will he be speaking? He says, these are things which should happen soon. Among the things which should happen soon in the end time, the greatest of all is which one? The second coming of Christ.
de la cual los
apóstoles
estuvieron preguntándole a Jesús.
They asked Jesus,
cuando Jesús
estuvo
en el monte
was
de los Olivos.
On the Mount of Olives.
Dice el capítulo 24
chapter
de San Mateo, verso 3.
In St. Matthew, verse 3
y estando
says,
sentado en el monte
as he
de los
sat upon
Olivos,
the Mount of Olives,
los discípulos
disciples
se
came unto him
diciendo,
privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be,
and
what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?
¿Cuándo serán estas cosas?
When will these things be?
De
in other words, the destruction of Jerusalem and the temple in Jerusalem. And he taught them that if they see the army surrounding Jerusalem, they should know that that's the time. And when they saw the army of the Roman general Tito in the year 70, when they saw the army surrounding Jerusalem, giving an opportunity for those who were in Jerusalem to go out, the disciples who were inside of Jerusalem, they came out of it. Well, because Jesus had told them, if you see Jerusalem surrounded by their army, you get out, because the time for its destruction has come, and those who were out should not return to her, because the time for her destruction had come. That was the sign for them. And the disciples of Jesus Christ were inside. They came out of Jerusalem because the Roman general Titus gave them time to get out without the army killing them. And they went out of Jerusalem. And now, the high priest and the rest of the priests and the Levites could say, this is the city that God has given unto us, and we have the temple here. So therefore, we are going to pray in the temple so that God can liberate us from this Roman army. They did not know that time had come for the destruction of Jerusalem. And Jesus Christ prophesied about the destruction of Jerusalem and of the temple. And since they did not know the time of their visitation, for that reason, all those problems would come upon them, the destruction of the temple, the destruction of Jerusalem. Since they did not know the time of their visitation, the visitation of God in his human flesh, in the person of Jesus.
La señal de su
now, the sign of his coming,
¿cuál sería la señal
what,
de su
what would be the sign of his coming and the sign of the
siglo.
End of the world?
En cuanto a la señal
about
de su venida,
the sign of his coming,
en San Mateo, capítulo
in Matthew chapter 24, verses
30-31,
it tells us,
la señal
then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. They shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. In other words, that the sign in heaven would be seen. And this sign, which would be seen, would be seen how?
En el cielo,
in heaven,
el hijo del viniendo,
the Son of Man coming
o sea, que
in
las
the crowds.
Verían,
in other words, the people would see
las nubes,
crowds.
Pero esa es la señal del
but this
hijo
is
del
the sign of the Son of Man in heaven.
Hombre,
there would be the sign the Son of Man, though the people
verían,
would only see
la nube o
a crowd
nubes
or crowds.
Otro de los
in the other
dice,
Gospels,
en
they
nube,
speak about a crowd.
Aquí en San Mateo dice,
but here in St. Matthew, they talk about crowds.
Y en Apocalipsis, capítulo
and in Revelation 10, chapter 10,
donde nos muestra la venida
where he shows us
de Cristo como el ángel fuerte
coming of Christ
del cielo,
as the mighty angel descending
dice,
from heaven, says,
vi descender del cielo
I saw another mighty angel come down from heaven,
nube.
Clothed with a crowd.
Señala que es una nube, pero
here,
no
it is a crowd,
en lo que
but
San Mateo
there is no contradiction
dice,
in what St. Matthew talks about,
dice,
about the crowds.
Aquí
and what is said here in Revelation,
en
that it will that be a crowd. And also,
en San Marcos o San Lucas,
in Mark and Luke,
nos habla
they tell us about
una nube. Vamos
a
crowd. Cuál de ellos es.
Let us see which of them.
En San Marcos nos dice que será
in
en
Mark
las
it
nubes,
tells us that there will be crowds.
Pero San Lucas es
but in Luke,
donde nos dice que será
that's where they say that
nube,
it will be in a crowd.
San Lucas,
let us see
Luke 21,
Luke 21,
capítulo 21, verso 21, verse 27, dice,
27, says,
entonces verán al Hijo
then
del Hombre
shall they
que
see the Son of Man
en
coming in a crowd with power
y gran gloria.
With great glory.
Cuando estas cosas comiencen
a when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. In other words, our transformation,
eso es la redención del cuerpo.
That is the redemption of the body.
Cuando veamos estas señales,
when we see these signs,
we have to
lift our heads up in heaven,
con nuestra
so that
mente
we
y nuestro corazón,
are with our mind and our heart and our sight
en
put
Dios y
in
su
God
programa.
And his program
y esperar
and to wait
nuestra transformación.
For our transformation.
Pero para esperar nuestra transformación,
but to wait for our transformation we have to be hearing
la voz de Cristo,
the voice of Christ,
voz de trompeta,
that great, great voice of trumpet making known to us all these things which should happen soon.
And
the things which we need to know so that we can have the faith, the revelation, be transformed and carried with Christ to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And now, whom will Christ send? And through whom will Christ be in the Holy Spirit manifested, making known to us all these things? Through whom will Christ be speaking with this great voice of trumpet of the gospel of the kingdom? And making known to us all these things which should happen soon, which we need to know. Let us see in Revelation chapter 22, verse 6 and onwards, where it says, and he said unto me, these sayings are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel. He sends who? His angel.
Para mostrar a sus
to show unto his servants
las cosas
the things which must shortly
pronto.
Be done.
¿A quién enviado?
Whom
a
does he send? His angel messenger. For what? To show his servants the things which should shortly be done. The things which we need to know
en este tiempo final.
In this end time.
Y Apocalipsis, capítulo
and in Revelation 22, verse 16, he tells us, Jesus Christ himself speaking, he says, I, Jesus, have sent my angel
to
testify unto you these things in the churches.
¿A quién?
Whom does Jesus Christ say that he has sent?
His
angel messenger. For what? To make known, to give testimony of these things. Which things? The things which should happen soon. To give a testimony of the things, of these things in the churches. Jesus Christ sends his angel messenger to his church.
El mismo ángel que le había enviado,
the same angel
a Juan el
whom
Apostle
he had sent to John the Apostle to give him the revelation of the book of Revelation. Now he sends him to his church to make known to her the meaning of these apocalyptic prophecies
símbolos,
which are in symbols
y que
and which speak about the things which should happen soon
en este
in this end time.
Los misterios contenidos
the mysteries contained
esos símbolos
in, this, in these prophetic symbols corresponding to the last day,
en el día postrero son
the last day they are opened by the Holy Spirit.
Y son revelados
they
al
are revealed to the angel of the Lord Jesus Christ and made known to the angel of the Lord Jesus Christ so that he makes them known to the church of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Y este angel mensajero
and this angel messenger is a prophet, a dispensational prophet,
the
prophet of the dispensation of the kingdom sent to Christ, to his church,
para darle testimonio
sent by Christ
de todas
to his church to
pronto,
give her the testimony of all these things which should happen soon
and
so that we can obtain the knowledge of all
tiempo.
That we need to know today in our time.
Ahora hemos llegado al tiempo
now we have reached in the time
en que necesitamos conocer
in which we need
todas
to know
cosas
these things which should happen soon
en este tiempo final,
in this end time
de las cuales el profeta Daniel en el capítulo 12
which
del libro de Daniel,
the prophet Daniel in chapter 2 of the book of Daniel he wanted to know them
no
but he was told that he cannot know them
tiempo,
in that time
le fue dicho esto.
Now you let's see how he was told
Daniel,
in chapter 12 of Daniel
dice,
on verse 4
12,
it says
pero tú, Daniel,
thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book
tiempo,
even to the time of the end
hasta cuando,
until when
Sería cerrado y sellado este libro.
Will this book be sealed?
Y las palabras contenidas
and the words which are contained in this book. Remember that the book of prophet Daniel is the revelation of the Old Testament. That is why
estos símbolos del
these
libro
symbols of the book of Daniel, let alone they appear in the book of Revelation.
Y ahora,
and now,
hasta el tiempo del fin,
until the end of the time,
sería
this book
cerrado y sellado,
will be closed and sealed.
Muchos correrán de aquí
para allá. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
Y yo, Daniel, miré,
then I, Daniel, looked, and behold, there stood other two, one on this side of the bank of the river, and the other on the other side of the bank of the river. This is Gabriel and Michael, one on each side, but is one who is standing on the river. That is Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. One said unto the man clothed in linen, which was upon the waters, you see. This is the Holy Spirit, in other words, Christ in his theophanic body from the sixth dimension. How long shall it be to the end of these wonders? And I heard the man clothed in linen, which was upon the waters of the river, when he held up his right hand and his left, as he also does it in the book of Revelation, in chapter 10, he raises his hand to heaven, and he swears that time will be no more.
And here, and
swear by him that liveth forever, that it shall be for a times and a half. In other words, for a year, and then the times, those are 2 years, and then the half, these are 6 months. In other words, for 3.5 years, which are the 3.5 years of the Great Tribulation.
And
when he shall have accomplished to scatter the power of the holy people, in other words, the Hebrews, all these things shall be finished. And the dispersing of the Hebrew people, you notice, has already been done, because now they are coming back to their land for the coming of the Messiah. That is the hope of all the Hebrew people who are returning back to their land. And I heard, but I understood not. You notice when the dispersing, the scattering of the holy people is done, and all these things shall be finished. And I heard, but I understood not. Then said I, O my Lord, what shall be the end of these things? And he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the end of the till the time of the end.
Y ahora nosotros estamos viviendo
and now we are living
en el tiempo del fin,
in the time of the end,
en donde estas palabras
where these things
son abiertas
are open
para ser dadas a
to
conocer
be made known
a la iglesia del
to
Señor
the church of the Lord Jesus Christ first, so that we can know them,
lo que necesitamos
we can know what we need to know today
tiempo,
in our time,
para tener así la fe, para
in
ser
order to have the faith to be transformed
Cristo,
and taken with Christ
a la cena
to the marriage supper of the Lamb.
Estamos viviendo
we are living
en el fin del tiempo,
in the end of time.
Y ahora,
now,
¿qué cosas estarán
what are the things that will
tiempo,
be happening in the end of time,
en el fin del siglo,
in the end of the century,
en el cual nosotros vivimos,
which we are living in?
Para el fin del siglo fue
for the
que
end of the century,
se llevaría a cabo
Christ said that he would carry out the harvest,
la cosecha.
In other words, the gathering, the harvest, where
el trigo será recogido,
the wheat would be, wheat would be gathered and stored in the storerooms.
Y para eso,
and for that reason,
el Hijo del Hombre,
the Son of Man would send
a sus ángeles.
His angels,
y
he would send his angels,
manojos,
and the tares would be tied in bundles,
fuego,
to be cast in the.
O sea,
in other words, the children of the evil one, which are the tares,
be
cast in the great tribulation,
donde será el lloro y el
where there will be the crying and
donde
gnashing of teeth,
el día
where
el horno,
the day that cometh shall burn them up
ha dicho Jehová de los ejércitos,
fire furnace,
no les dejará ni raíz ni rama.
Saith the Lord of hosts that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. Malachi chapter 4, verse 1.
Pero para los que temen el nombre,
but for those
Señor,
that fear my name,
en el mismo capítulo
in that
4,
same chapter 4,
el verso que le sigue, que es el verso 2,
the next
dice,
verse 2, but unto you
los que temeis mi nombre,
fear my name,
nacerá.
Shall the Son
de justicia,
of righteousness
y sus alas,
arise with healing in his wings.
¿Y qué significa eso?
And what does that mean?
A vosotros los que temeis mi nombre,
to you that fear my name,
esos son
those
los escogidos,
are the elect,
la iglesia del Señor Jesucristo,
the church of the Lord
luego,
Jesus Christ, and later,
los escogidos del pueblo hebreo,
the elect
que son
of the Hebrew people, who are the 144,000 Hebrews,
nacerá el sol de justicia,
the Son of Righteousness would be born. And what is the birth
dijo,
of the Son of Righteousness? Christ said, I am the light of the world.
El sol de justicia.
He is the Son of Righteousness.
Por eso,
for that reason,
en el monte de la transfiguración,
the Mount of Transfiguration, when
allí,
he was transfigured there, his face shone like the sun.
Y en el Apocalipsis, en
and
el
in Revelation,
y
in chapter 1, and also
10,
in chapter 10,
aparece el hijo del hombre,
appears
el
the Son of Man, the mighty angel who descends from heaven,
como el sol,
with his face like the sun,
viniendo,
coming
en el día postrero,
in the last day.
El sol es el astro rey.
The sun is the
y Cristo viniendo en el día postrero,
the king star.
Como el león de la tribu de Judá,
Christ
como
coming in the last
reyes,
day, he comes like the lion of the tribe
señores,
of Judah, king of kings and Lord of lords.
De toda la
that is the king of the whole world.
El sol es el astro rey, y
the
Cristo
sun
es el rey
is the
reyes, y señor de señores.
Is the king star. Christ is the king of kings and Lord of lords. That is why the second coming of Christ is represented in the birth of the Son. And those that fear my name, will the Son of Righteousness be born. In other words, the second coming of Jesus Christ will be born,
will
be fulfilled, the second coming of Christ, as the Lion of the tribe of Judah, as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, in his reclaiming work and in his wings. And what are the wings of the Son?
Las alas del sol de justicia,
the wings
sol de justicia,
of the Son of
Cristo,
Righteousness,
los
wings are the ministries of the two olive trees,
Moses,
the ministries of Moses and Elijah. That is why
San
Jesus
Mateo,
in St. Matthew
16,
chapter 16, verse 27-28, he said,
el hijo del hombre
the Son of Man will come with his angels, and then he will pay each one according to how his works will be. The coming of the Son of Man with his angels, the coming of the Son of Righteousness, shining and bringing healing in his wings for those who fear the name of the Lord, to give us faith to be transformed and taken with Christ to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Now we have seen the things which we need to know in this end time. And for that reason, Jesus says, I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto these things in the churches. In other words, the members of the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, the people will not have to be scratching their head to try to interpret the Bible, but to have their spiritual eyes well open and to know that Christ is the one who said, I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. And that is the prophet of the dispensation of the kingdom sent by Christ to his church in the last day. In other words, in the seventh millennium, which has already begun if we add on the calendar the years of delay which are there. And that is the prophet messenger in whom the manifestation of the angels of the Son of Man will be, which are the ministries of Moses and Elijah, the ministries of the two olive trees, who will be manifested in the last day, so that through the manifestation of those ministries, the great voice of trumpet comes, in other words, with the message of the great voice of trumpet, the gospel of the kingdom, making known all these things, and in that way, calling and gathering all the sons and daughters of God, because that message of the great voice of trumpet, the gospel of the kingdom, which rotates around the second coming of Christ, as the Lion of the tribe of Judah and King of kings and Lord of lords, it will enter directly into the soul of all the sons and daughters of God, directly into the soul of all the sheep, the good pastor, the good shepherd, the Lord Jesus Christ, and will open for them the understanding in the soul and in their minds, and will open for them the scriptures, and then we will understand them, and we will say, this is what I was waiting for. These divine promises are what I was waiting for. Now they are open. These promises, they are open now. These mysteries, and now they are so simple that even the children can understand them, and they can receive these promises being fulfilled, the fulfillment of these promises. And now, through the angel sent by Jesus Christ to his church, all the sons and daughters of God, all the sheep of the Lord, will hear the voice of Christ, making known to us what we need to know today,
in
this time in which we are living in. Do you notice how everything is simple? No one we have to be scratching the head, studying, to try to discover these mysteries, but only to receive the sent one of Jesus Christ. And through the sent one of Jesus Christ, we will obtain the knowledge of all these things which should happen soon, of the things which we need to know in this end time, to be called and gathered and be prepared to be transformed and be taken with Christ to the marriage supper of the Lamb in heaven. And now, this angel is not the Lord Jesus Christ. He is only an instrument of Jesus Christ sent to his church in the last day, and is a member of the mystical body of Christ redeemed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is why when John the Apostle wanted to worship him in the book of Revelation verse 6 up to 10 and Revelation chapter 22 verse 6 to 10, the angel told him that he should not do it. He did not accept the worship of John, and he said that he told him to worship God, because this angel is not the Lord Jesus Christ. He's a prophet, a dispensational prophet sent to the church of Jesus Christ with the divine revelation of all these things which we need to know today in the time in which we are living in. The things which we need to know today, you notice a simple form in which we make them known to his church, to his children, to his sheep, in this end time, through his angel messenger,
whom
Christ will be in the Holy Spirit manifested, speaking to his church, anointing that prophet messenger, and that prophet receiving the revelation of God, the revelation of Christ, and making it known to all the sons and daughters of God. And in that way, what we need to know today will be made known. Will be known to all the sons and daughters of God. You see the way established by God in his word to make known all these things which we need to know today. And there is no any other way. This is the way established by Christ, and no other person has a better way than the one Christ has to make known to us what we need to know today. There's no any other way. He says, I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. The sent one of Christ is the messenger who comes making known to us all these things which should happen soon. And
Esa es la forma.
That is the way
de conocer of a knowing cierta, the, estas cosas que nosotros debemos conocer.
To know the certain science, the things which we should know, to not be human opinions, but to be the revelation of Jesus Christ for His church in this end time.
Y toda revelación tiene que venir
and every revelation has to come through who? Through a prophet. That is why he sends a dispensation of prophet, his angel, messenger.
Lo que necesitamos
what we need
hoy.
To know today.
Lo que
did you see how simple, how these things would be made known in a simple way? Receiving the one whom Jesus Christ sends to make known these things.
Y así todos somos enseñados
and
por
in that way, we are taught by Jesus Christ through the Spirit of Christ in His angel messenger, giving us a testimony of all these things which should happen soon in this end time. It has been for me a great privilege to be with you, giving you the testimony of what we need to know today. And we saw the simple way in which we would obtain this knowledge.
May
the blessings of Jesus Christ, the end of the covenant, be upon all of you and upon me too. And soon, may the number of the elects of God be finished. And soon, may Christ through His angel reveal to us all the things that we need to know today. And soon, may we be transformed. May we all be carried to the house of our Heavenly Father, the marriage supper of the Lamb, the eternal name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. We speak about Christ making known the things which Christ said that He would make known to us in this end time. Because these are things that we need to know in this end time. The things which He said that should happen in this time. And in that way, not only being a believer of God, only by history, but also of what He is doing in our time.
And
that way to have God not only of the past or of the future, but also of the present. A God that fulfills what He promised for this end time. God bless you and keep you. And thank you so much for your kind attention.